So we can do a lot. It's got to be represented simply as a part of the proposal and the next group of international patients or professional candidate. To present paper, document, and certificate.
Mr. Chairman, ladies and gentlemen, the starting point of this presentation is practically the last slide that you have seen in a presentation of Mr. Milan Dikic during the previous day conference about what we call water governance diagram, and where we show on a vertical axis the GDP per capita for the countries in the world. On a horizontal axis, we have available water resources practically in each country, which we calculate as internal water resources plus some percentage of the external water resources. With this red dot, we put the place of Serbia. As you can see from this diagram, if you remove these lines, this is practically somewhere in the center of the diagram, which shows that we are somewhere in the middle, both in availability of water resources, also with GDP or economic strength of this society. This blue dots around it are neighboring countries. Here I have shown three upper from Serbia is Bulgaria with a little bit less resources, but little bit more GDP, Macedonia on the left with a little bit less resources, and Bosnia and Herzegovina, which has more water resources than Serbia. But all these countries, like we had seen yesterday for the different countries, shows that similar problems, the countries with a similar place on a diagram have similar problems in water management, which can be seen on a next slide. Yesterday you have seen from Mr. Zavatsky's presentation the Danube River Basin. The Serbia is practically one-tenth of Danube River Basin, both in area and population, and it's placed somewhere in the middle of its catchment, which means that in our river basin management strategy we had to have in mind the upstream countries but also the downstream countries, and we see that practically whole Serbia, 95% of Serbian territory falls within the Danube River Basin. The annual precipitation as a source of our water resources is somewhere in the middle of the world, the average about 730 millimeters, but it differs from about 500 millimeters in the north to over 1,000 millimeters in the mountainous region, particularly in western or southwestern areas. This 730 millimeters creates a total internal outflow from the territory about 15.5 billion cubic meters, and that would be relatively decent, but not low, but decent. What is our advantage? That we have Danube River Basin, that from the upstream countries we receive about 160 billion of cubic meters. It creates good conditions, particularly for the northern parts of the country, but also creates certain problems regarding the flood protection, excess water removal, etc. Also, there are some smaller river basins which drains to the Adriatic Sea and the Aegean Sea. Basic hydrological indicators are shown on this table, and we see the Danube as one of the biggest river in Europe, practically, and one of the biggest in the world. River has very good conditions regarding the low waters and average water. Low waters of Danube is nearly 2,000 cubic meters at the average in Serbia, which creates good conditions for the water management, irrigation, etc. But also we see that the biggest national river, which is called Velika Mora, which has about 40,000 square kilometers of catchment area, has relatively low average water, about 230 cubic meters, but very, very low low waters, just 35 cubic meters, and that creates a lot of problems in water quality production. On this slide, we just have seen I've shown the basic hydrogeological units of Serbia. There are diversity of structures and conditions for creation of groundwater systems. About 75% of our drinking water comes from the groundwater. Out of it, more than 50% is coming from alluvial aquifers, and that gives good conditions for the protection and has to be improved for the protection of this very valuable source of drinking water. This conference about one part about the climate change in Serbia, as you can see, it is shown yesterday, there is some temperature trend in last 100 years about plus 0.7 centigrades per this 100 years. And this reflects on a precipitation trend, which is particularly on eastern part, even 15% below the average in this moment. Yesterday you have seen that for the Danube River Basin, predictions is towards a further increase of the temperature, which will consequently decrease the availability of water resources. Some our investigation that Dan Dinkić done was showing that for one centigrade there is of uprising of the temperature, there is a decrease of about 20%, and this we have to have in mind when we create our strategy for the next period. From this natural, we are moving to these main socio-economic indicators. Dr. Šojić in the last presentation yesterday showed the macroeconomic indicators for the Serbia, which are not too much favorable. Our GDP is about 30 billion of euros, but the problem is that fiscal balance is about 4 to 7% of GDP each year. That leads to increase of external debt of Serbia. At this moment is about 25.7 billion of euros, which is somewhere in the border. Dr. Šojić said yesterday of 80% of national income of GDP, and this means that we have to think in the future about possibility to further have loans and how to do that investments without too much having loans for these new investigations. The water management in Serbia has a very long tradition, and some parts of Serbia, northern parts particularly, we have a tradition which is more than 200 years for different aspects of water management. The major investment cycle we had after the Second World War, that major investment cycle did the upgrading of the capacities for both design companies, construction companies, research institutes, etc. And we had very good basis. A lot of this capacity we still have, but are scattered, and we had to coordinate the efforts to keep these capacities capable to do the investments that we need in the future. In this period, a large number of water systems has been built. We have now problems to maintain this system because of the, as you have heard, the price of water is very low, and these problems are from the 1990s due to the economic problems, war in the region, and the sanctions, and we still have a lot of those problems today. Our accession towards the EU started with some harmonization with EU legislation. Our water law is new water law is enacted in May 2010, and practically with this law we started the harmonization with EU legislation. It's still far from being fully harmonized, but this is the first step. as you've heard from David, we had Michaud, we had a lot of problems with organization and splitting of responsibilities between the different ministries. A particular problem is that public utilities, water distribution companies and wastewater companies are under the different ministry than the water ministry. It's a ministry of public administration. This is one of the key water management problems. On this slide you have seen, I just don't want to go into it, just to see who is responsible. You see so many institutions that this is also a problem. Also we have seen this slides that gives some water management problems in the different water sectors. Public water supply, although we had a lot of problems, is still good in many cities. People drink a lot of good water, good quality water, but there are some problems, particularly in the northern part of the country, in Vojvodina. There are some problems in Morava River Basin, and also we have in the summer months shortages in some cities. About the groundwater, there are some problems in over-exploitation in Vojvodina, and also there are the losses in the networks are over the acceptable levels. We need to do a lot to solve these problems, and our estimation is about 1.5 to 2 billion euros to meet the requirements of different directives that regulates this public water supply. You see that Vojvodina is the area with the most problems regarding drinking water quality. About wastewater evacuation, as we also seen from previous speakers, this is the worst segment of water sector. We have very low percentage of polluters with equipped with wastewater treatment plants, less than 10%. The public sewage is over 55%, still not adequate. And in this area, we need a lot of investments. According to our estimation, it's 4 to 5 billion of euros, and this is really, really significant investments for Serbia. Although this situation is regarding water quality is not so good, the quality of our waters are, I could say, acceptable. On the upper slide, this red line shows that from 1970 to 2014, the Danube at the entrance in Serbia and Bezdan is showing the constant improvement of quality due to the measures that were done upstream in countries like Austria, Hungary, Germany, Slovakia and Czech Republic. But also this blue line shows that at the exit, at Radujevac, Iron Gate Gorge, we see that at the exit the Danube is not at least as the same quality as enters, which shows that our industry practically is not working and that self-purification potential of our rivers is such that managed to solve the most of the pollutants that comes into our waters. The bottom diagram is GDP, BOD at the mouth of our biggest national river, Morava, and we see here that practically stagnates during the time. This is due to the lack of wastewater treatment plants, and the amount is of BOD is higher than for the Danube because of the lack of treatment and natural conditions. Next slide shows some of the cities which needs to build wastewater treatment plants, and we see here that, for example, for our national interests, we had to first solve the smaller cities or bigger cities on a smaller water courses, or even smaller cities which are on sensitive zones like the reservoirs or water supply. On the other hand, the business interest of the companies which probably could come to Serbia is to solve first the bigger cities like Belgrade, Novi Sad. our intention is to find the balance between these two interests. Regarding the other segments of water sector, we very brief, the flood defense, although we had really, really extensive floods, we still managed to fight most of the problems on the bigger rivers. We have problems on the smaller water courses. The drainage is also relatively good and well developed on more than 2 million hectares, but we have problems with maintaining of these systems. On the other hand, the irrigation is not adequate. We only have about 40,000 hectares covered with irrigation, and we have, this is mainly a problem of the economy of the agriculture. When we see in total what we have as operating expenses for existing system, this is about 500 million of euros annually, and when we add the needs for the development in the next period, we calculate it here as a 25-year period. It comes that we have for this 9 to 10 billion that we had to invest both for our own needs and the needs to align with the EU directive. We need about 350 million of euros investment annually. All in total, this is 1 billion of euros annually, and in this moment we have a total in the water sector about 350 million, and so this discrepancy between this the needs and existing money that comes to the system is very big, and this is one of the main problems that we have to solve. Regarding the harmonization with EU legislation, as we said, we started with the new law. Most of this 8 to 10 billion we need for the additional funding to meet the EU directive. This directive largely coincides with the needs of water sector, but we think that somewhere EU requirements are excessive given the practice effects and actual pressures on water resources of Serbia. The measures required by EU integration process show the compass a long enough period, by our opinion, about 25 years, but not in a manner that will compromise Serbian macroeconomic stability. At this moment, we are in the process of drafting a Serbian water management strategy. And in this strategy, the main objective is what we have in an integrated water management, practically to have a harmonized water regime in the whole Serbia, which ensures the highest economic and social effects while honoring international agreements. But to have this long-term objective, we have a priority objective, and this is to establish appropriate water management system. That means to provide the needed legislative, institutional, financial and other resources and conditions to meet this objective. This strengthening water management system is practically tied with need to increase and to solve the problem how to increase this turnover from 350 million to 1 billion of euros, and we think that this is possible to do, but with this needs and reform of financial system of Serbia, strengthening of capacity in all levels, like Mr. Notaro said, we need a balanced approach to decision making, which by which we mean that we still have to prioritize to take on a national level, and also we had to have a strong bond with scientific research and professional organization to enhance the state administration capacities to be able to carry out all this process. The first and major influence is this financial assumption, because of considerable financial resources that we need. We need to create a better macroeconomic environment. This means that we need to have our own resources, our own national water fund, to be counterpart to the international financial institutions. We need to gradually increase the water tariff from what we have now, which is 0.6, which is not economically and it's not enough price for water sector, and its main, as we know, that 75% of income into water sector is coming from the water tariffs, we definitely need to increase this. We need to have the adequate pricing and charging policies to do that. On this diagram, we've shown that at this moment it's 0.6 for the domestic, about one euro per cubic meter for industrial. We had to increase to amount of 1.6 euro per cubic meter in the end, which gives average about 1.3 euros per cubic meter, by our opinion, to meet what we have to do in the next 20-25 years. Also, we did some projections what to do, from which funds we can do what is necessary, and we practically rely both on the national funding and also the international financial institution, as well as EU accession, IPA funds and other funds for doing this business. Besides economic, we definitely need to strengthen the bond between water utilities and the national water management system, since at this moment the national two water utilities are under the different ministry, and we think that this is one of the prerequisites for the improvement of whole water sector. To be able to implement the new investments, there is a need to create to strengthen the capacities in a regional centers, and one of the possibilities to create a national regional capital project implementation centers. Also, we have to strengthen the human resources practically on all levels, both on the national administrative bodies, but in all other sectors, and practically to do the efforts on a national scale to preserve and upgrade scientific research organization, as they must become an important contribution to public administration capacity. And also this requires a reform of educational system, both on secondary and tertiary levels. Conclusions are practically given in a document, the Book of Absurd, that you received. This is once again what I've already said, so I would conclude with this.